Brilliance of Ramadan, 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 brilliance of Ramadan. Brilliance of Ramadan.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, was salatu was salamu ala Sayyidil Mursaleen, Amma Ba'ad, Fa'udhu Billahi Minash Shaytanir Rajim, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. As salatu was salamu alayka ya Rasulullah, as salatu was salamu alayka ya Habibullah. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that a person who sends one time durood or salutation or salawat upon me, Allah azza wa jal sends 10 mercies upon him. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salatum wa salaman alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya habiballah. Dearest viewers of Madani Channel, Alhamdulillah azza wa jal, once again we are blessed with this beautiful opportunity to learn ilm-e-deen. Today's topic is generosity. Generosity is a beautiful quality. It's a praiseworthy quality. And a Muslim, a believer, should be generous. Because our religion, our deen teaches us to be generous, and our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our true role model, was very generous to the extent that he never said no to a person who asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for any need. As Ala Hazrat Imam Ahl Sunnat Sayyiduna wa Mawlana Imam Ahmad Raza Khan Fazil Barilvi Navvarallahu Markadahu says very beautifully, Wah kya judo karam hai shahe batha tera, nahi sunta hi nahi mangne wala tera. Wow, what a generosity! O King of Medina, O King of Batha, that your beggar never hears the word no from your lips, Ya Rasulullah. So as ummatis of that great generous Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, generosity should be in our nature. And alhamdulillah, because of the barakah and blessings of this beautiful characteristic of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, generosity is displayed by Muslims all over the world. But when you do generosity, you should also try to give your best in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Things that you love the most, you should give in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. As it is mentioned in Quran Kareem, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never reach the goodness until you spend in the path of Allah that thing which you love the most. Sadrul Afadil Hazrat Allama Maulana Sayyid Muhammad Naimuddin Muradabadi Alayhi Rahmatullah Al-Hadi writes in Khazainul Irfan under this ayat that Hazrat Sayyidina Hassan Basri radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that something or wealth which is very much loved by a Muslim, he should spend that in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Your most favorite, your most beloved thing, you should spend in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Even if it is one date. So it's not about quantity, it's not about the size of something that you are giving in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. What is most favorite, what you would love to use for yourself, you should give that in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Amir al-Mumineen, Hazrat Sayyidina Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to buy bags of sugar and give as charity. People asked, why don't you give the cost of that much sugar in money form and give that as charity? He answered to this question, he said, sugar is very much liked by me. I love sugar a lot. And I desire that I should spend in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal that which is beloved to me. Subhanallah. This was the way of our pious people, our pious elders, Sahaba Ikram, and other pious personalities, Salihin, Sufiya Ikram, Awliya Allah. There's a beautiful narration regarding Hazrat Sayyidina Abu Talha Ansari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He had most gardens amongst the people of Madinatul Munawwara, and from amongst all his gardens or his farms, there was a garden called Baruha. He loved that very much, which was in front of Masjid An-Nabawi. Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to go to this garden and used to drink the good water of that garden. When this ayat was revealed, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ, he came in the barga of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, from all my wealth, Baruha garden is most beloved to me. I give that as charity in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, and I deposit the thawab of it by Allah, and I treasure it by Allah. So in the akhirah, I can get the thawab of this sadaqah. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayka wa sallam, wherever you want to spend this garden according to your own opinion, you may spend this garden or you can give away. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied to Hazrat Abu Talha Ansari, Bakh dhalika malur rabihun. Very good. This is very beneficial wealth. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that what you have said, O Abu Talha, I have heard it. My opinion is that you should give this as a charity and make this as waqf for your relatives. So Sayyidina Abu Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, I will do this as you have commanded me. Then Hazrat Sayyidina Abu Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu made this garden as waqf, gave as charity on his relatives, on his cousins. Subhanallah, from here we learn that Sahaba Ikram Ridwanullahi Ta'ala Alayhim Ajma'een, they used to look for their best things to give in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. It is mentioned in Tafsir Khazin under the ayat, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ, that Hazrat Sayyidina Zaid bin Haritha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he heard about this ayat, that this ayat is revealed, he brought his best horse and he said, I give this as charity for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave that horse to his son, Sayyidina Usama bin Zaid radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Sayyidina Zaid radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Ya Rasulullah, I had intention to give this as charity. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that your sadqa is accepted, your charity is accepted. Alhamdulillah, from these few examples, we learn that a Muslim, a believer, first of all, should be generous, and secondly, he should try to give best things in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. The wealth that we have is of three types. Aqaid Alam Nuri Majassam, Shahi Adam Bani Adam, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that bondsman, human being, he says, my wealth, my wealth, my wealth. Only three kind of wealths are his wealths. Rest are not his wealths. Number one, what he has eaten and consumed it, destroyed it, it's gone. Number two, what he wore and made it old. And number three, he gave and treasured it for the akhirah. And whatever else is there, he will leave for others. So which means that that is not his. So when it comes to wealth, we must see it in this way. Yes, we need to eat, we need to weigh, and then the third option, a conscious Muslim should always have, is to spend maximum in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, display his generosity, so on the day of judgment he can see its benefit and he can be pleased with the reward that is granted to him because of his sacrifice, because of his giving in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Aqaidu Alam Nuri Mujassam, Shahi Adam Bani Adam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, who amongst you is like that who regards the wealth of his inheritor better than his own wealth? Sahaba Ikram submitted, Ya Rasulullah, who can be like such a person that he takes the wealth of someone else as dear over his own wealth? So Sarkari Dualam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, our wealths are only that which we send ahead in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, which we give as charity. And whatever wealth we leave behind, that is the wealth of the ear, that is the wealth of the inheritor, so that not yours. So dearest viewers of Madani Channel, there's a great lesson for all of us to learn, that we should give maximum in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. Dearest viewers of Madani Channel, wish we can spend our wealth to build a masjid, or spend our money in other work of thawab jariya, sadqa jariya. As far as progeny, children are concerned, if any wealthy person hopes that after his death his children will do isale sawab for him, or some work of sadqa jariya for him, he is mistaken. As we have seen these days, that how the ears, they fight with each other, and they even kill each other. There is bloodshed. They become enemies of each other because they want more and more from the inheritance. So therefore, develop this mind to give in the path of Allah, to be generous, to have ithar, to sacrifice, because this would help you on the day of judgment. Our Buzurgan-e-Deen, pious people, they were very advanced in this department, that they would send their wealth for the akhirah, for the benefit of akhirah, and for the work of sawab and sadqah jariyah. Hujjatul Islam, Hadrat Sayyidina Imam Muhammad bin Muhammad bin Muhammad Ghazali, alayhi rahmatullah al-wali, writes in Ihya al-Ulum, that Hazrat Sayyidina Bishr bin Harith, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, was on the deathbed. He was very sick and he was about to die. Somebody came and begged from him. He, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, took out his shirt and gave it to him. And he borrowed a piece of material, a cloth from someone, to cover his body. And he passed away in that borrowed piece of cloth. Did you notice that our aslaf, our pious elders, our pious predecessors, they were so greedy for good deeds, for sawab, that even at their deathbed, they would not leave any opportunity go where there was chance to earn sawab. Our master, Ala Hazrat, Imam Ahl Sunnat, Mujaddid Deen Millat, Sayyiduna wa Mawlana, Shah Imam Ahmad Raza Khan, Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayh, writes in Fatawa Razaviyya, Volume 10, page 84. Imam Ibn al-Imam, Kareem Ibn al-Kiram, Hazrat Imam Muhammad Baqir, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, arranged for himself a beautiful coat, or overcoat, and he went to the bath area, and a thought came into his mind, that I should give in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, because this is beautiful and it's my favorite. So immediately he called his servant. So he came near. So Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Baqir radiyallahu ta'ala anhu took out that overcoat and gave to the khadim, to the servant, and told him, go give it to so and so needy person, poor person. And when he came out from the washroom area, the khadim, the servant, said that what was the reason to be so quick and be in hurry to give that overcoat? So Hazrat said, what if my niyat changed by the time I came out of the washroom area? Subhanallah. So these are the holy people, the pious people, people of Allah, who do not delay in doing the good deed. As soon as the thought came, he gave in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. They never trusted their nafs. Dearest viewers of Madani Channel, it's very sad that most of the people do not give in the path of Allah. And if they give, they think about it a lot. They look very worried. They seem very worried. And then they do not give easily. They let the needy person come and humble himself, and they'll cause humiliation. And that too, they give zakat, which is the dirt of the wealth. And they give in very short quantity, small quantity. People do not do their proper calculation of zakat. And then they give it in a style as if they have done a great favor. Whereas a person who is giving zakat, he should not think that I'm muhsin or I'm doing the favor. In fact, he should think that the person who has received zakat from me, he is muhsin, he has done the favor, because he has made my wealth clean. He has taken that dirt away from my wealth. And many people who give in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, they want their names to be mentioned. They want, they must be praised in gatherings. And here and there, that is not the way that Islam teaches us. A person came in the court of Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Hassan Mujtaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he gave a letter. Hazrat Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu said immediately, your need is fulfilled. So somebody said, O Nawasai Rasul, O beloved grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you should have read his letter, his note that he has given. And then according to his note, according to his letter, you should have given him. So Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala replied, so had I done that, he would have been standing in front of me in humiliation. And on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have asked me. So therefore, I immediately granted him. I didn't even want that he should stand in that humiliation for that much time, which takes to read a letter. So subhanallah, these are the great people. They know how to give charity, and they are role models, and we must learn from them. Instead of making the needy person circle around and move around and go pillar to post to meet you with appointments and etc., then to you busy in your meetings on your calls, and make the person sit and wait for you, and then you help him, and then to tell him too many things of doing favor and ihsan. That's not the way of our pious elders. Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Zainul Abideen radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, A person who gives beggars, when they beg from him, he is not a generous person. He is not sakhi. Sakhi is that person, generous is that person who takes care of the needs of the people in his own accord. Mean he makes an effort and he tries to learn the need of the people and he reaches them and he gives them. And he does not have any greed of shukriya from them. He does not hope that these people must be grateful to him or thankful to him. Because he believes in complete thawab and he believes firmly and he has yaqeen and certainty in the thawab which is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which he will be granted on the day of judgment. There's a beautiful story in Ihya ul-Ulum that teaches us a great lesson that a person went to the house of his friend and he knocked at the door. So the friend asked him, "What brought you here?" The friend told him that I am indebted for 400 dirham. So I need that much money to pay back my debt. So the person of the house, the possessor of the house, his friend, he gave him 400 dirham and he started crying. So his wife asked him, "If it was too hard for you to give 400 dirhams to him that you are crying, so you should not have given." He said, "This is not the reason that I'm crying. I'm crying that why I did not know his condition without he coming and telling me." So he had to go through this difficulty and this humiliation, and he had to come to my door and knock at my door, and then only I helped him. I should have known his state, I should have known his condition, and I should have gone forward on my own and help him. Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Hassan Mujtaba radiallahu ta'ala says, one day some food came in our house after being hungry for one meal. We did not have the meal and we were hungry and then food came. My father, Mawla Mushkil Kusha Ali al-Murtaza Shere Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and my younger brother, Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and myself, we finished eat. But our Ammi Jaan, Sayyidatun Nisa Fatimatul Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha, still had to eat. So when she forwarded her hand towards the roti, towards the bread, a beggar came at the door and he said, "O Binte Rasulullah, O daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I did not have meal for the last two times, and please help me and fill my stomach." So Hazrat Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala says that my Ammi Jaan held her hand immediately and she gave me order that take this food and give to the beggar, because I'm hungry for one time and he is hungry for two times. For the last two meals, he did not have anything in his stomach. So please give this food to him. Subhanallah. This is the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is Ahle Bayt. This is Khatun Jannat. Sayyidatu Nisa'i Ahlil Jannah. She is Ummul Hasanan Kareeman. Tayyiban, Tahiran, Shahidan. She is part of the body of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She is Lady of Jannat. She is Hur of Jannat in the form of human being. Look at generosity. Look at the jazba and the enthusiasm to give in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. So we need to follow these role models and become generous. Muslim community should always be generous. Unfortunately, the greed of love of this dunya and wealth and money and comforts and luxuries has overpowered us these days. We need to reform ourselves. We need to change our lives. We need to change our thinkings and give more and more in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. So the day we close our eyes, our treasure is lying and waiting for us. And inshallah Azza wa Jal, we will then enjoy the sawab that's there for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to give in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, to sacrifice for our brothers, for our sisters. And may we help our deen, our masajid, our madrasas, our jamiat. Particularly, Dawat Islami is doing fantastic work throughout the world. And the work is growing day by day. So many new masajid and centers coming up. All requires funding. So please come forward and give your charities and fundings to Dawat Islami. May Allah accept our humble efforts and ibadat that we are doing in the month of Ramadan particularly and in other times. Ameen bijahin nabiyil ameen sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sallu alal habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Salatun wa salamun alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulullah.
Brilliance of Ramadan, 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 brilliance of Ramadan.